Today I'm going to show you the different ways that I color shrink plastic. They're all super easy methods, and I think you guys will find this video useful. So, let's get started. The method I use most often for coloring shrink plastic is colored pencils. I feel that it works the best, it's easy to control, and has good pigment. Especially these pencils. I got these on Amazon, and they were super cheap, but you want to know why? Because they're super short! They're half size. Pencils. But anyway, I'm going to draw a few hearts so you can get the feel of what these look like. Start here. I'm gonna go ahead and color it in. By the way, this is frosted shrink plastic, and I've been able to find frosted shrink plastic wherever I find normal shrink plastic, but if you can't find frosted shrink plastic, you can just use a sandpaper. I've also heard that acetone works. I've never tried it, so I cannot vouch for that method, but for colored pencils, definitely frosted shrink plastic. Finally, I'll make a blue heart here. Try to make it about the same size. So those are the colored pencil hearts. Next, I have some permanent markers, and these are basically the same as Sharpies. I also have some chalk markers here, and I like to use markers for outlining just because you get a bolder outline. I personally don't like to color with markers, but I know there are shrink plasticers out there that do, and it works just fine for them. Let's see here, let's take a green, and what other color should we do? Let's do purple, I guess. I'm gonna go ahead and color this in. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I find it rather hard to layer ink on shrink plastic with markers. I just feel like it's hard to get an even color. I'm gonna go ahead and make a green heart here. Whoa. I love that all my hearts are totally different. The good thing about permanent markers, though, is that you can use them on non-frosted shrink plastic. So if you need a good outline or if you need to color it in, it's perfect. I'm gonna go ahead and make a heart with the chalk marker. These are not really good for coloring, and this one I haven't even used. Ink's not even coming out yet. Forget that one, I'm gonna use a pink one. This one I have used. Again, I usually like using the chalk markers for outlines because they look really nice. I love the colors. And this is a brand called Posca. It's a Japanese brand, but any chalk marker should work. These are fine tip Posca markers, so they're very thin. And I like that for my outlines, but they also sell big fat ones too. So whatever works best for whatever you're trying to make is my answer to what kind of pen should I use. Personally, I don't like these colored in either because the ink tends to look a little bit chunky after you shrink the plastic. The next way I like to color shrink plastic is with chalk pastels, and I have a whole video on how I color with chalk pastels, so I'm just gonna make a quick heart, but I'm gonna link the video up top and you can check that out. And personally, I think chalk pastels look the best. But again, it just depends on what kind of creation you're making with your shrink plastic. Aren't those colors beautiful? And these chalk pastels are just from the dollar store. I've been wanting to try out, you know, more expensive brands of chalk pastels to see if they work better or if they're, you know, more highly pigmented. But, you know, these dollar store ones work perfectly. Let's see, I don't have a yellow, do I? So let's go with this yellow. With the chalk pastels, I usually don't color it in too darkly, but wow, that's horrible. For this piece, I'm gonna go ahead and color it in. You're gonna have a lot of excess chalk, so you're gonna wanna tap this off into like a garbage bag or something before you cut it out, or you're gonna get chalk everywhere. For the last two methods, acrylic paint, nail polish, I'm going to be adding the color after I bake them. So now I'm gonna go ahead and cut these hearts out. There's one, let's do another down here. Now I'm gonna go ahead and cut these out. Here are the hearts all cut out. The pink chalk pastel one actually isn't dry yet, so I'm trying not to touch it too much. Here are the clear ones, the non-colored ones. I'm gonna go bake these in my oven toaster, whichever way you wanna call it, and I will be right back. I am back, and we're going to look at them in detail in a second. But first, let's go ahead and color these guys. The first method is the nail polish method, and I don't use this too much just because it takes so long to dry, but it does look really nice and glittery. This is also a good way to seal your shrink plastic pieces if you have a nice top coat, glittery top coat, you know, whatever you want. For the other piece, I'm gonna use this red nail polish. It's a really fine glitter, and I think it's gonna give the piece a little more color than this one. Here we go. I mean, this is pretty much like painting your nail. Next, I'm going to be coloring with some acrylic paints, and these are really nice when you're working with larger pieces. Sorry it's a little hard to see, but I will show you the pieces in detail at the end. Usually when I paint on shrink plastic pieces, it is the back side, and then the other side is going to be the front. Now for the purple. Then I need a little dot of paint. There we go. This piece is a little lopsided because I didn't flatten it in time, but it'll work for this video. I love pastel colors. They look so good. I'm going to go ahead and add another layer of paint on each piece. Here they all are. Let's ignore the paint blobs right there. Let's take a look at the colored penciled one first. Here they are. I did color them a little bit roughly, but I think this is probably one of the best ways to color shrink plastic. Here's an example of some pieces that I use coloring shrink plastic. The outline is done with marker. Speaking of marker, here are the permanent marker pieces. Again, permanent marker is not a great way to color shrink plastic because the color gets so dark. It's really hard to control the piece, I feel. And personally, I only like using markers for the outline. Next, we have the chalk pastel one, and it looks okay. It's vibrant, it's bright, but you need to seal it really well or you're gonna get chalk powders all over everything. Personally, I like using chalk to make really light gradients. And again, I'll link the video. It looks like this. The pieces look great, and yeah. Next, we have the chalk marker piece, and it looks okay. The coloring isn't even, but if you use it as a background color, it actually looks really good. So, that's okay. Next, we have the nail polish pieces, and I actually have not colored that many pieces with nail polish, but if you're looking for a very simple color, I think it looks really nice. Actually, the red one looks really, really good. Finally, we have the acrylic paint pieces, and as you can see, it's not an even coat. I could have given it a few more coats of paint to look great, but since it is the background, once you flip it over, it looks a lot better. And you can ignore the pen outline. I didn't cut that very nicely. But yeah, so if you want nice shiny pieces like that without doming, acrylic paint is the way to go because then you just flip the piece over and it looks great. So what did you guys think? Which was your favorite way of coloring shrink plastic? Let me know in the comments down below, and let me know if you color shrink plastic a different way. I would love to learn different methods as well. So, that was all for today. I will be doing more shrink plastic videos, so if you like them, please subscribe, and check out my previous ones. I'll leave a playlist down below and up here, and that is all. Bye!